Tina Kafalis missed the opening ceremony, choosing to keep training at high altitude in Greece. Now she is finally in London, getting used to the weather ahead of Sunday's marathon. Her goal, a personal best time, under 2 hours and 40 minutes.
Just being able to be here after kind of the roller coaster ride for so many years is definitely just a blessing for me.
Kafalis got a sneak preview of the route on Thursday and filmed part of it on her iPhone. But she wasn't sure she'd be here, even when she qualified in April as Greece's sole female participant in the marathon, given the harsh economic climate back in Greece.
But just given the crisis and the crunch, they've been, you know, forced to cut back on how often they give their stipends or if they give it at all. So that then puts a crunch on us.
Greek Americans heard about her story and decided to sponsor her, right down to buying her training shoes. And that led to sponsorship at home.
I've been fortunate enough to have a sponsor, Echo. It's a member of the Greek Petroleum Group and a major player in the industry, so they've been supporting me, fortunately.
Kafalis hopes other members of the diaspora will emulate her willingness to tough it out in Greece.
Greeks are very successful abroad, and so I think that now we have to try and make the country a way so that Greeks can be successful in Greece as well.
And what better way to show Greek spirit than participate in the one Olympic event named for a Greek city?
Even though people know I'm not going for medal, I think that they're very proud of having a Greek representative in the marathon. And I think that's important for Greece to have that representation whatever place we end up getting. Just to show that we're still here and we're still fighters and we're still running strong.
She'll be running strong on Sunday in Greek colors. Jim Bolden, CNN, London.